Hello everyone, my name is Alexei. I'm product manager in data and analytics engineering team here at SAS. In this demo, I'm going to show you how Python can be used within SAS Studio. First of all, we will have a quick look at Python code editor in SAS Studio that allows you to develop Python programs without leaving SAS Studio interface. Then I'll also show you how you can exchange data between your SAS and Python sessions that actually makes this integration even more powerful. And then we will jump into the next part of the demo, and I'll show you how you can use Python programs that can be developed either in SAS Studio or in any other IDE. So how you can bring these programs into SAS Studio flows that allows you to build visual data pipelines in a low code environment. So let's get started. I'm now logged in SAS Studio, which is a very rich integrated development environment for data engineers and data scientists. One can connect to a variety of data sources that you can see here on the left side. It's possible to develop Python programs that we will have a look at, SAS programs, and as well as it's possible to create visual data pipelines in a low-code environment that is called SAS Studio Flows. So let's jump straight to our Python program editor here. I can open this from this menu, and then just to give you the idea how this Python program can look like, I can copy-paste a few lines of code here. If we have a closer look at this program, then we can mention that I automatically get syntax highlighting specific to Python language. Also, if I would type some Python statements here, then I can get automatic suggestions about the possibilities of methods and functions that I can use in Python. So this is really cool. Let's have a look then at the first three lines of code here. This is a pretty typical Python program that one can develop. I import some modules from Python libraries, then I use a specific function here, and then I print the information in the log. If we execute this, it indeed outputs the information into the log, so I can see the output of my program on the right hand side. Okay, this is about the standard Python methods. But also, what else is available in SAS Studio with Python integration is the ability to exchange data between our SAS session and Python session. With Python integration, I have built-in SAS module that allows me to communicate between Python and SAS. This module contains a few callback methods that allows this integration. And then, well, one of these methods is the method that allows me to write my SAS dataset to Python data frame so that I can use this data frame in my SAS program. In this specific case, I'm going to take class table from SAS help library and write this into my data frame called df, and then I'm just going to output the content of this data frame. This is something that we can see now on the right side here. This is Python data frame displayed in my SAS log. This is cool. Also, vice versa, if I would like to do some processing with this data frame and, for example, to calculate another column and add this in this data frame, I can do this as well in Python, and then I can write this data frame from the Python data frame df to my SAS dataset, and I can specify any location for this dataset. In this specific case, I can output this into work library, but in general, I can use here any library that is available from my libraries that I can access through SAS access interface. I can execute this as well. So, and let's have a look what we get. As you can mention, this dataset is now written in SAS table, so I can also access this from this menu on the right side. If I pull this up a little bit, then we can see that now the column that we have calculated in our Python program is written in my SAS dataset, so that now I can use this further. All right, I think we now have a good understanding about Python program editor and also about that we can exchange data between our SAS datasets and Python data frames. Let's now apply this knowledge in practice and see how we can make use of Python programs within SAS Studio flows that allow us to build visual data pipelines in a low-code environment. To do so, I'm going to switch to my project folder that I can access on the left side here, and then I'm going to open up feature selection flow that we will use for this demonstration. Before we jump in the flow itself, let me quickly introduce the use case that we would like to solve here. I know that there is some shortage of charging stations for electric cars in North Carolina. So I would be interested to understand where I can place new charging stations. And in order to do this, I would like to prepare a data mart for a few data scientists who can then build a model based on this data mart and predict the right location of these charging stations. One of the first features that I would like to calculate here is a number of cities that are located near a specific road segment. In order to calculate this feature, I would need to get access to a couple of data sources. First of all, I already have the information about the cities in North Carolina. This information is stored in Snowflake database, and as you can see, I have the information about the city and its geographical coordinates. But the other important piece of information that I would need is stored and is only available for me in the file format that is called shapefile. This is a pretty typical file format for storing geographical coordinates. So this can be a very good use case where it makes sense to bring Python in. I know that Python has a nice library called GeoPandas that allows me to easily read in and process shapefiles. Let me go back into my project and open up the Python program that I have already included in my SAS Studio Flow and have stored inside my project. I can do this also from SAS Studio Flow. Let's quickly navigate through this program. So, thanks to GeoPandas module that I can use, it's really enough for me to write one single line of code here in order to read the file, read my shapefile into Python data frame. And the rest of the program is actually just about applying a few additional methods that are available in GeoPandas module that help me to set the right coordinates and then transform the data into the format that I would like to use for further analysis. In the very end of the program, I can also specify that I would like to output my final Python data frame into the next iteration of my SAS Studio Flow. So let me close now this program and navigate back into my SAS Studio Flow. Now from here, let me quickly run this node within SAS Studio Flow. I run only one node just to give you the idea about the data that is coming from this shapefile. We can quickly have a look at preview of this data in preview data tab. As you can see, we now have information about road segments and also individual points that are located on these segments. Each of these points has geographical coordinates x, x and y. So this data format is now very similar to the one that we had in our Snowflake database, so now we can intersect and compare this data and calculate how many cities are located nearby each of these road segments. Just before we do this, I would like to quickly show you that you can use any other SAS Studio transformations alongside with Python programs. For example, if I'm interested in calculating the length of the specific segment and including this information into my final data mart, I can easily do this. In a very similar way, just to give you the idea about the data that we will get as the input for our further transformations, I can quickly run a couple of other nodes that I have connected with my Snowflake database. And here, finally, I can just drop some columns that I wouldn't need for the analysis. As you can see, we now have a couple of temporary data sets ready to be passed into the next node here. First of all, we have information about the cities here. And on the other side, we have information about road segments and the individual points that are located on these segments. So we can use this information to calculate how close a specific city to a specific road segment. In order to do this, I would like to bring in another Python program here, just to give you the idea that we can use Python nodes at any point in our SAS Studio Flow. What this program does actually, it reads in a couple of data sets that are coming from the previous iterations. So we read in the information about the cities and the traffic. And then I'm also using a GeoPy module and distance method here in order to calculate the distance between two geographical coordinates, the one that represents a point on the road and the other one that represents city location. I can easily execute this step also from within SAS Studio Flow. As you can see, it now gets executed and iterates over road segments and city's location and calculates the distance. When it's done, we can have a quick look at data preview. And as we can see here, we have calculated the number of cities that are located nearby each of the points on a specific road segment. So now we can proceed further. And actually, since I had the information about my road segments flattened by individual geographical points, then the next logical step would be to aggregate this information on a road segment level. This is where I can proceed with another SAS Studio step that allows me to configure this grouping in a very transparent and easy to understand visual interface. Also, I can configure the logic of aggregating my columns here. And we can run this node here. It's completed very quickly. And then in the preview data, we can have a look at the pre-final data mart. As we can see here down below, we have our data aggregated on road ID level. We have information about the length in miles of a specific road segment, number of cities located near this segment, and also about the average daily traffic. Just before I will hand over this data mart to data scientists, I know that there is one more interesting feature that is available in my Google BigQuery database. This information is about how many charging stations already exist in this segment. So I'm just going to use a join transformation within SAS Studio and add this attribute to my existing data set that I created previously. I can run this node quickly from this interface and see how my final data mart would look like. When it's done, we can quickly have a look at something that we're going to hand over to our data scientists. If I will just pull this up a little bit, then we can see that now, in addition to the data that we had previously, we also now have the information about number of charging stations that are located near a specific road segment. At this point, I'm ready to release the data mart, so it could be used by data scientists for modeling. Actually, speaking of modeling, a data scientist can build a model in any environment they're comfortable with. This can be a SAS Model Studio, which allows to build visual model pipelines, or this can be a SAS program. And yes, it's also possible to do this in Python. I can easily add another transformation node here that would contain my Python model. So this allows me to embed Python at any point of my data and analytics process. But my demo comes to the end at this point. The very final thought that I would like to leave you with is about the location of Python programs that I've been using for this demonstration. As you might have already mentioned, I've been using the programs that are stored separately from SAS Studio Flow. So the code of these programs is not saved within SAS Studio Flow, but instead the program is referenced from its location. This means that if you have many assets developed in Python, you can already bring and use them in SAS Studio Flows to augment your data pipelines with Python where it makes sense. Thanks a lot for watching. I hope this was useful. And now you'll share my excitement about how powerful the integration of Python in SAS Studio can be. Thank you, and see you next time.